Shalom, welcome back. First and foremost, I want to give all glory, praises, and honors to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai. I want to give double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone. I want to say salutations to your brothers that's doing this work in sincerity and in truth. Today's lesson is basically going to be about when the prophesying stops, all right? When the prophesying stops. Now, this is mainly directed at brothers that have been in this faith. Actually, hands-on brothers that have been in this faith on the highways and byways, pushing this word, right? When you do something for so long, you know, brothers can't imagine not doing it, right? You know, going out, whatever day you go out to camp, pushing this word, interacting with people, putting up the videos, doing the sit-downs, so on and so forth. But the spirit is coming to a point where those things are going to stop. When Esau makes this move to cut and censor the internet from the way that it is, all right, certain camps out here in Chicago I can speak on, we have not been out because of the shelter-in-place order. Man cannot be on the street in certain groups. You get harassed by the police. There was video that the beloved elder Uriah put up. It wasn't a GMS camp, but they were out on the street corners teaching, and the police rolled up and basically told them they gotta move, man. Alright? Now all these things are happening because we are coming to an end, and brothers, you gotta take comfort in that this thing is at the end. Alright? Because, you know, a lot of brothers, myself included, I'm going to say a lot of brothers, myself included, sometimes don't feel right if you're not preaching and speaking his word. But that's only a portion of the story, man. All right. Pushing that word, making sure it went out to the four corners of the earth, getting this word from our apostles and passing it on down to the next brothers that just listen to us. That was part of the story, and that part is coming to an end. We are not going to be prophesying all the way through hard martial law, you know, with troops and tanks on the street, even though you're going to see certain camps out there attempting to do that. And that's going to show a lack of wisdom. It's going to show a lack of prudence. All right. Now I'm going to go into the scriptures, you know, and let you know everything has an end point, man. Even prophesying and even speaking his word. All right. So in the days and in the weeks and months coming, understand that if we make it, you know, Yahweh right desire, we're those men, it's going to be by faith and mercy. And that's it, man. Faith and mercy. All right? But let me go right into the scriptures. Let's go into, let me get this right here. Let's go into the book. 1 Corinthians 1 and 21, it says, "For after that, the wisdom of the Most High, the world by wisdom knew not the Most High. It pleased the Most High by the foolishness of preaching to save them that believe." Right, so us preaching for however many years that you've been out there, myself 10 plus, the elders, apostles 30 plus, and this message goes, you know, even to the brothers that just came this thing months or to a year. Regardless of how long you've been out there preaching, it was something to show your faith. Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai is in the act of pushing out these end time prophecies and basically these end time judgments. All right. So when these things start to happen one after another, as we've been seeing with this coronavirus and everything that's gonna come after it. We are getting to those times where it's truly going to be a famine of the word. Brothers speak on it a lot. Brothers say that a lot. But really ponder those times and what you're going to do in those times. All right? Because that's when your faith is going to have to shine the brightest, is in those times, man. All right? Yes, you can know all the precepts. You can know all the breakdowns. But when you can't preach anymore, and that part of the story is done away with, and we enter the next part, which is salvation. You still got to keep your mind and your thoughts and your wits, man. All right? And rely more on the spirit and rely more on faith more than ever. All right? So let's keep moving. Let's go to the book of let's get this right here. 1 Corinthians 4:20. It says, "For the kingdom of the Most High is not in word, but in power." And Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai, is no doubt showing his power, man. He's bringing down this economy. He's bringing down Esau's kingdom. He's making things happen out here. All right. He's ushering in that digital, that digital currency, that implantable chip, which is going to be the mark of the beast. All these things are at the door, man. All right. And because all those things are at the door, and that transition period of basically surviving this Hunger Games type scenario, which is about to be brought up on the world, that prophesying is going to stop at a certain point. All right. And brothers got to be mentally, spiritually prepared for that. All right. Let's keep going. Let's go to a couple precepts in Proverbs. Let's go to the book of Proverbs 22:3. It says, "A prudent man foreseeth the evil and hideth himself, but the simple pass on and are punished." Right. So I perceive it's going, like I said before, it's going to be brothers out there trying to prophesy in front of troops and in front of tanks. And when you're doing it at that point, is you really doing it to push the word and have Israel repent, or are you just out there because you want to be out there and you want to be seen or whatever? So it's coming to us, you know, like I said, it's coming to that head in the scriptures. Everything has an end, and even prophesying has an end. All right? And whether this be it or not, and things kind of go back to normal, we'll see. But if this is the end, and, you know, all brothers know the prophecies of 2nd Ezra. You know, 15th, 16th chapter. Our brothers know the certain prophecies in Revelation. So when we come into these times, it's going to be basically surviving the game at that time, which is a movie, you know, brothers should check out, man. It's, you know, a game of survival. All right. And when you really go into that word remnant, you know, it means surviving. We're going to have to survive these times, man. And that's, you gotta get your mind and your spirit ready for what is coming, man. All right? Because a lot of things are about to change, big time, man. So this is just a warning to the, you know, to your brothers out there, man. Once the prophesying stops, man, you can't be down in the dumps. That's when the true, your true spirit and faith is really gonna be tested. All right? Let's keep going. Let's go to the book of Proverbs 12:23. "A prudent man concealeth knowledge," all right, "but the heart of the fools proclaimeth foolishness," right? So there's coming, like I said, that time on earth where if you wise, you gonna shut the hell up, man. You gonna shut the hell up, man, and operate in the spirit and operate on faith. You know what is supposed to transpire on this earth because you know the prophecies. Right, we got the lessons from our teachers and apostles, and hopefully those things are inside of you right now, all right, to give you hope in the dark days that are ahead. So when those times come, like the scriptures say, a prudent man concealeth his knowledge, man. It's a time when there's a parable of the foolish virgins that trim their lamps, and then you have the five wise and the five foolish. It's a time, man, you got to go find this truth somewhere else. All right, you got to move around, man, because there's no excuse. This truth has been everywhere, literally everywhere, and in every scenario, mainstream news, all over the internet, on all the street corners around the world. The people, the man, the hopeful elect, the ones that are meant to be sealed, had a chance to get this word and repent. All right. Now we're still pushing it out as we speak right now, but in the spirit, those days are numbered. All right. Let's keep going. Let's get this right here. This is the book of Ecclesiastes 3. I'm gonna read at 1, and I'm gonna jump down. It says, "To everything there is a season, and to every time, to every purpose under the earth, right? So there's a time and purpose for everything. This is verse 7. A time to rend and a time to sow, a time to keep silence and a time to speak. So we are approaching those days of keeping silence. We are approaching those days where we're not going to be prophesying. All right? We're approaching those days where I'm going to get the scripture. I'm going to end it off on that. Where the Most High is going to release those four winds, man. And they could already be released. And this is just, you know, the wrapping up of it. All right? Because the apostle did state that he believed that the elect are sealed already. All right? And Yahar-Rotzah, you know, that they are. All right? So just keep that in mind, man. Really keep that in mind. You know, lean on your faith. Lean on your prayer. Fast and whatever you got to do, lean on that in these times, man. Lean on Yahar-Bashim Yahawashai on the times that's coming. All right? When the prophesying stops. Let me grab that and I'm going to end it off. This is Revelation chapter 7, verse 3. It says, actually, let me start up. Actually, let me start at 1. It says, and after these things, I saw four angels on the four corners of the earth, holding the four winds of the earth, and the wind should not blow on the earth, nor on the sea, nor on any tree. And I saw another angel ascending from the east, having the seal of the living power. And he cried with a loud voice to the four angels to whom it was given to hurt the earth and the sea. So this is going into the time of judgment, that judgment day. All right. When really shit is about to hit the fan. And the only way that you're going to make it is through the faith and mercy of Yahar-Bashim Yahawashai. Those are the days that we're coming into. And like I said, we're not going to be prophesying all the way up into those times, man. All right? Your boy Trump extended this thing all the way to another month, man. And people are out here hurting, man. Big time. So, like I said, you're going to see a purge-like spirit in the earth. A very cold spirit in the earth. Because those are the times we're truly living in. Verse 3, saying, hurt not the earth, neither the sea, nor the trees, till we have sealed the servants of our power in their foreheads. And like I said, you know, I believe, you know, I speak as a man. The apostle already said that he believed that the elect are pretty much got to be basically sealed, man. So those angels are going to let loose of those four winds and heavy destruction. It's coming. War, famines, civil unrest, civil wars, race wars. All right. Even more death and plagues. Okay. Economic hardships. You got everything is coming back, man. You know. You're going to have, you know, people eating each other soon, man. Food banks are going to run out. Food in the stores are going to run out. Like I said, that's cannibalism is coming back. All these things are written about in the scriptures for a reason. And when those times truly commence, man, hey, you better be plugged in heavy, heavy in the spirit. All right. Heavy on faith, on which way to go, which move to make, which decision to choose. Okay. So that's pretty much the point of this lesson. I hope some brothers got some edification out of that. I want to give all glory, praise, and honors to Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, and I will say Shalom the next time.